abstract sculpture really didn't enter my realm until later on in my life. And so the reason why I'm attracted to functional pottery is that it has a use in my home. It has a use in my daily life. And my inspiration is drawn from that conceptualizing of use and functionality. But on a broader scale, I grew up on the prairie on the plains of Kansas, and that sense of space and the geometry and the way things are orchestrated on the landscape became my sort of personal composition for arranging the dinnerware on the table. And so objects, barns, buildings, houses on the prairie, that's my inspiration. If you want to get into color and surfaces, it's all about those crazy sunsets in Kansas and the colors and the shifts between the seasons. And my colors and my palette reflect those shifts in the seasons. Decisions you make in your art making process are established very early on in your childhood. Things that are taught to you by your family, friends, your father. And those issues come up as content in your work. And so by shifting intentional content into work is the artist's voice. It's the thing that resonates as to who you are as an artist. And that's what I focus on. Well, I think my goal overall as a teacher is to connect with the creativity that I think that everybody has. I hear this often that I'm not creative, I don't have anything to say. And I don't believe that for one moment. I think we all have something that we can say. We all have something in our background. And so my belief as a teacher is that if they can walk out of that room being changed 1 degree or 1%, either through a technique or a conceptual thought, then I've done my job. I've pushed that idea forward. So if they just walk back into their studio and go, I'm going to center a little differently, or I'm going to pull the clay up a little differently, or I'm going to think a little harder about the content in terms of why I'm making that round pot or that outer round pot, all I want to do is just cause that conversation in their own studio to continue past this experience. So I think one of the amazing things about ceramics in general is that it allows you to problem solve in a way that most people don't problem solve. You have to take a fairly abstract lump of clay and make something out of it, a cup, a bowl, a teapot, a vase. And along with that comes engineering and problem solving. And I've often felt as myself as a problem solver. I just love to have things in front of me that need to be solved. And I think that's a lot about teaching, how to unlock, you know, what's there and allow people to figure out how to problem solve for themselves. So the problem came along for me about teapots in that traditionally they would have a clay handle either across the top or off the back. And it's the first thing that breaks. It's the first thing that gets hot. It's not that comfortable. And so I put down making teapots for a long time until I came across this idea that literally had to do with staring at the garden hose in the yard and thinking, oh, that might be interesting. And it was cutting up the garden hose in the yard and stretching it over a teapot that gave me the idea that this could be a functional handle that doesn't break, it's soft and supple, it's sensitive to the touch, right? And it doesn't get hot when you hold it. And that was it, you know? And I think that all good work, all artwork of all kinds, including pottery, has to have a point of entry. You have to grab the viewer. And that is one thing that viewers gravitate to. They go, what is that? Then they touch it and they go, ooh, ah, that feels good. And I've done my job. I brought that person to my work and they've touched my work. So it works and operates on a conceptual level as well as a functional level. Why did I pick clay? I don't think that I necessarily picked it. I think it picked me. And I responded to it almost immediately. Its malleability, its ability to be anything you wanted it to be, which was something as a young adult. The world is large. You can be anything you want to be if you work hard at it. And I think clay was the ideal metaphor for that, that I could make pots that people enjoy out of this kind of simple material. So in a way, I think clay found me. I'll say that clay found me in the sense that it sort of gave me direction in life. It gave me a sense of purpose. It got me up in the morning. It allowed me to have something in my life that I could focus on, that I could do well. then share with other people. So joy and beauty and grace and balance and